Hi guys, you're welcome to my channel. If you're new on this platform, my name is Afolake and this is Distinct Interiors. And on this channel, we'll just share home improvements, DIYs, you know, things that help you improve the outlook of your home, your space, how to decorate, how to put little pieces together to make your home really inviting and aesthetically pleasing. So if this is what you always want to keep watching, hit that subscribe button and continue to follow this channel. But today I just want to show you or unveil to you the process of me working on my backsplash, because in my kitchen I currently don't have a backsplash, and I wanted to show you before and after and how it has turned out to be. We moved into this home and of course there was no backsplash in the kitchen, and we usually would have to wipe down, you know, the walls because of stains of cooking that splashes on the wall. And that's why backsplash is really important even in your home. It also improves the aesthetics of your kitchen. It makes that place look beautiful and inviting. Backsplash come in various ways and there are different cost implications to backsplash. You can always get one even in Dollarama. Yes, you can get a backsplash at very cheap and affordable in Dollarama. But if you're looking for something that will give you class beauty, you need to upgrade. You know what I'm saying? You need to step up and look for something that would really give you that vibe that complements everything around you with the outlook or the presentation of what it looks like. So don't just get anything because you just want to have a backsplash. For me, I look at compliments. You know, opposites attract. You can complement things by color, by design, by style. You can also do form and function in the sense that you're looking at shapes, alternate shapes to be able to complement stuff when you're dealing with design. So for me, I was looking at, my theme here is gray and white, and I just wanted to continue that theme here. I could have used a white for my backsplash, but it would just flush in everything. My cabinets are white, my island table is white, my island chairs are gray, and of course you have my island lightings that are also gray. My electrical gadgets like my cooker, my fridge, my microwave, my dishwasher, they're all silverish gray. So I thought it was good to continue with that theme, right? To continue with that color and just blend everything. So we went searching for a backsplash, and it was really difficult for the design I wanted really to use. I didn't want something too busy, and I was looking around, you know, looking at other people's backsplashes in their homes, and eventually found this one. And it's really nice. It's glass. It is glass, yes. And it really took my handyman a lot of effort to be able to cut it. He went from finding the right tool to be able to cut it and ordering another one from Amazon. I really pitied him, but because that was what I wanted, he said he wouldn't do that for anybody again. He won't buy this particular one, but he actually gave me what I wanted in backsplash. So I'm very excited to unveil to you the before and then the after. So tell me what you think and hit like and subscribe. And also put in the comment section what other things you want me to share with you on this channel. I'll keep bringing it to you, DIY, and things that help you to be more efficient, more cost-saving, and things that will also improve your style and beauty in your space. So take a look, guys, and see you. Hey guys, this is just an update on my kitchen backsplash. This is a progress. I just want you to see what I see behind me really coming up so good. So we'll be able to complete this one today. Just showing you the progress that we've made so far. I'm loving it. I hope you are. Finally, my backsplash is ready. We've finally completed the backsplash in my kitchen.
And I love the tile, I love the finish, I love the color, I love how it blends with everything else in this space. Take a look, guys, I'm sure you'll love it as well. And I'm going to be decorating it back the way it used to be, put it right, and you know, just make my kitchen glamorous once again. So guys, let's go decorate my kitchen. So we're going to be wiping them down. This originally was just a beauty. Sometimes I spray this to just give it that aroma. So I put this in this corner. I also have this jar that I put, you know, different kinds of sweets and candy, so that when I have guests and children, they always love to come to this jar. So I put it where they can find it, just here. And finally, I have this little cup. It's like they use it for shots, but I don't do shots. But I got this from Royal Tyrell Museum when we went to Calgary. And I felt it was just a good piece to have in your home, just to remember our visit during our vacation last year. So this, just put it in the corner here. Then let's move to the other side. Here, I would put this one here. I love this. This is really nice. Turn it over on this. Then this is like almost a junk bowl, really. But I love the silverish effect. Just kind of picked a few silver from my cotton rail. I really don't have so much silver here, but just like my kitchen sink and my cotton rail. But this is just like a dump junk, but it's decorative. We have some paper. When we have bills that come in and we need to fill, we throw it here. We have hand cream to, you know, just cream your hand on the way out. So I just put this here. So, and I think it works with my silver tone coming out from the backsplash as well. I have this that stands the iPad for some good music when I'm downstairs. So I put this on the corner here. It's also decorative. So this is how it stands here. Then I can put the iPad on it whenever I'm downstairs in the kitchen. Let's see how this fits. So I think I can swap this. I usually will have this on this corner just to have decor to my kitchen. But maybe I can put this here. I think it's beside the cooker. What does it look like? Anyway, I'll decide. Then, of course, my kettle and stuff. I'm going to give this a good wash. But usually, I'll put that here beside the plug. Then, this always stands beside it. Then I have this wire mesh. This is a basket I always just use to elevate the things I put here, like bread. So I have, sometimes I put my bread here, most times. Then I have my coaster for my, when I have hot pot out of the burner. So I put that here to be able to receive the hot things. So this is my decor. Then, okay, I have this one I usually put on this corner. I can just change up the paper towel for something bigger. So this goes in this corner. Then I put this beside the burner, the cooker area. I put this here just for easy grip when I'm cooking. Yeah. So this is just my mini spot, decorative spot. So I decided to switch things up a bit. Just move the decorative pieces around. This is same as usual. So I changed this one. I took it from another space and I put this here. So what do you think, guys?